New York City is the American Mecca of fashion, and when I moved there a few years ago, my first question was, how do I dress like I'm from New York City? And after trial, error, and a lot of creepily staring at people on the street, I finally cracked the code on how to dress like you're from New York City and not from small town USA. This video is also a collab with Amay Margot. She is an awesome lifestyle YouTuber. She visits New York a lot, so I'm really excited to share with you her take on how to dress like a New Yorker. Rule number one, don't be afraid of mixing patterns. New Yorkers love an outfit with personality, and sometimes the patterns you think will clash the most actually make the greatest combos. Try sticking to a monochrome theme for a more subtle pattern mixing. I revamped the black-on-black outfit with a flowered midi skirt from the early 2000s and paired it with my Picasso t-shirt from Yes Style. My black dachshund bag add to the monochrome theme, yet keep the outfit toned down and not insane looking. Rule number two, put your own spin on a classic fit. Everyone knows the classic t-shirt, jeans, and sneakers combo. But what if the jeans were a skirt? What if the shirt was in Chinese? Figure out how to make this classic combo not like other girls. I put mine in pigtails, so I'm obviously different, and you're ready to go broke window shopping in Soho. Also, 10 Duchess points to whoever can tell me in the comments which YouTube merch I'm wearing around my neck. Rule number three, get inspired by New York street style.
Hey everyone, my name is Amay and I am a lifestyle YouTuber. One of my favorite cities to visit is New York. It is such a fun place to be and it's just such a cool city. This first outfit is inspired by an element of street style that I see a lot of people wearing, which is baggier, looser fitting pants and a smaller, tighter fitting top. So I just paired this pair of straight leg black denim jeans with this striped cropped tank top. And I also paired it with this gold belt and some golden jewelry to match. And I paired this look with my Doc Martens as well because that is a shoe that I see so many people wearing.
Rule number four, shop in the men's section. You'd be surprised how many fashionable New Yorkers get their clothes in the weirdest places. I got this army tie-dye shirt from the Forever 21 men's section, but I dressed it up with some Franco Sarto sock booties and a vintage leather clutch that was my mom's in the 80s. My black cuff is from a Beautiful Creatures book signing, my sunglasses are from a stand in Chinatown, and my jewelry is all from Yes Style. But paired all together, I feel awesome enough to buy up 3 pairs of Chanel shoes in Bergdorf Goodman. And then return them all because actually I don't have money. Rule number five, you'll need that one classy outfit. Whether you're going to a dinner meeting with some colleagues or you have an elegant date planned with your special friend, you'll need an outfit that complements the clean structural lines of Manhattan's fancy parts. A funnel neck shirt is always a go-to as it elongates your neck and shoulders, while an accordion pleat always gives the perfect balance of clean-cut lines and femininity. Add some black booties, some understated jewelry, and a quality clutch, and now you look like a Manhattan boss girl. Rule number six, defy the seasons. Who said beanies are only for winter? If it makes you feel like that red 100 emoji and it's not too scorchingly hot you want to jump into the Hudson Commando, then rock that beanie, dang it. This outfit is pure hipster Brooklyn with my crazy tutu, my cropped Chinese cat tee, and my black docks. But the beauty of Brooklyn is that no one there gives a flip, so I'll fit right in.
This next look is inspired by another element of New York street style that I see people wearing all the time, which is layered shirts. So I've just layered this long sleeve striped shirt underneath a graphic tee, and I really like this layered look. And I've just paired it with this pair of pink cargo pants and Doc Martens, of course.
Rule number seven, get ready to turn your day outfit into a night outfit. New Yorkers don't like to go home every few hours when they need a costume change, so better bring a few changeable accessories along with you so you'll be prepared for wherever you need to be. I stuck with cool tones that can carry me from day to night, yet I kept the dress flowy and the fit dressed down with docks so I can still be casual throughout the day. Throwing on some sunnies and a black backpack also helps. For night, I simply let down my hair and cinched in my waist with a black belt, and I'm immediately more ready for a nighttime meetup with my friends. Rule number eight, dress according to your environment. I'd wear this outfit in the Jewish parts of Brooklyn, like Crown Heights, Midwood, or Borough Park, in order to celebrate the Jewish holiday of Shabbos. It takes place on Saturdays, and we Jews usually dress up quite fancy for the occasion. But there are subtle rules of modesty and style that I factor in when putting together outfits. This colorful A-line skirt is from an Orthodox Jewish brand and covers my knees, which is important. My jewelry is understated, my grandmother gave me this necklace when I was 13, and my funnel neck top and sock booties help lend an air of elegance to the fit. And now I look ready to pray in a Brooklyn synagogue.
This last look is pretty different from the other two, but this is the kind of outfit that you would wear to go to the theater or a Broadway show. And this look honestly reminds me a lot of Blair Waldorf. I even paired it with a headband to kind of match her style. But I just have this black and white houndstooth skirt paired with a black turtleneck and black flats and a black bag and some dainty jewelry as well.
Rule number 9, thrifting is your friend. New Yorkers love to thrift, and it's often where they find their best pieces. I found this vintage 70s Cheongsam blouse in an LA thrift shop, and I thrifted the Pac-Man t-shirt directly across the street. The maroon pencil skirt I thrifted in Boston, but altogether, I have an outfit that tells a story, and that's the best kind of outfit that you can have in New York. Rule number 10, when in doubt, throw on some statement pieces. The trick to being a New Yorker on the go is to throw on a trusty statement piece over some boring basics. I chose this asymmetrical t-shirt to go with my usual black tee and pencil combo, but I made things a bit more fun with some flashy red Converse and a pair of blue sunglasses I picked up in Santee Alley in LA. And now it looks like I tried hard, but in reality, the statement pieces did all the talking for me. Bonus rule, just be yourself. The reason why New Yorkers are so fashionable is because whatever they wear, they do it with confidence. I splattered this army jacket with paint myself, which means that no one is going to have a jacket quite like this. I chose to pair it with a pink beanie and black docks, which means that when I walk down the street, I will look unique. I don't care that my choker is 3 years old and outdated, or that I'm pairing an office skirt with grunge. It's my style, and that's what makes it pop.
I want to try something new on my channel. I want to give a shout out to people for watching all the way through the end of this video. So if you want to be shouted out in the next video, just write Ian Sommerhalder down in the comments below.
Hello, Ian.